Music has changed drastically throughout history. From the way we play it, to the way we listen to it, and even the way we understand it, music has been constantly evolving. And today, I'm going to be discussing the history of Western music. When discussing Western music, there are six eras: medieval, Renaissance, Baroque, classical, Romantic, and modern. In this video, I will describe the history of all of those except for modern and medieval. With the Renaissance being a time of introducing new thought and ideas to theology, science, math, and art, there were many changes for how we understood music. The music of the time was also greatly influenced by the invention of the printing press, which allowed for musical ideas to spread rapidly. Despite the movement of humanism, the church remained essential for music education with its increasingly complex polyphonic choirs. Polyphonic meaning more than one melody. The music was mostly vocals, with the lyrics being in Latin, which didn't change until the Protestant movement, when people started worshiping in whichever language they chose. Secular styles of this time included the madrigal, chanson, and German lied. These styles pushed boundaries to create more emotion in music by including major and minor chords. Composers of this period were mainly from France, but later Italy became a really important musical center. Some well-known early composers are going to be up on the screen right now, but I don't know how to pronounce them, so I'm just gonna leave them there. The music from the Baroque period used many increasingly complex harmonies, with many melodic lines playing at once, making major and minor chords. A defining part of this era was the contrast in dynamics, volume, and instruments. With the harpsichord being the most prevalent, the main instruments of this era were the harpsichord, pipe organ, viol, recorder, lute, and flute. Bach, who was often referred to as the face of the Baroque period, commonly used the pipe organ. Other composers of this period were Vivaldi, who was famous for the Four Seasons and Gloria, and Handel, who wrote Messiah. The musical styles of this time were the concerto grosso, the sonata, and the suite. Overall, this period showed a big shift toward musical complexity and harmony. Many of the songs from this period are still sung in choirs today. The classical era took much inspiration from ancient Greek culture, with much emphasis on elegance and class. The music of this era had very clear transitions, with phrases being balanced, usually in groups of four bars, and there was a lot of homophonic texture where there was a melody over a chord base. During this era, the harpsichord was replaced by the piano. The most well-known classical composers include Beethoven, Haydn, and Mozart, and the main musical styles were symphonies, concertos, and sonatas. Haydn wrote 107 symphonies, which were similar to the style of Mozart symphonies, but the symphonies of Beethoven were extremely revolutionary. It's for their intense emotional depth that Beethoven is often referred to as the bridge between classical and romantic period. The romantic period was a movement to leave the constraint of the classical period. This led to the use of bigger orchestras, bigger pitch range in those orchestras, and more emotional expression. Program music is music that represents a person, place, or thing, and it is commonly used in soundtracks for plays. This led to the use of motifs, which represent a person, place, or idea. Whenever a certain character would be introduced, their motif or theme would play, and it would, in a way, describe their role in the play. For example, the themes in Romeo and Juliet have much contrast, making the flow of the music very poetic and lyrical. Motifs are still used in movies today. Here are a few well-known modern examples of motifs. I found it really interesting while researching for this video just how many ideas from over 500 years ago are still in use today. Music has evolved a ton to get to the point that we are at today, and it'll continue to evolve until the end of the times. Yeah.